Torrent of darkness among the dusty trees, the moon was a ghostly gannet tossed upon cloudy seas. The road was a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor, and the highwayman came riding, riding, riding. The highwayman came riding up to the old inn door. Over the cobbles he clattered and clashed in the darkened yard, and he tapped with his whip on the shutters, but all was locked and bared. He whistled through to the window, and who should be waiting there but the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess, the landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into a long black hair. And dark in the dark old inn yard, a stable wicked creek, where Tom the ostler listened. His face was white and peaked, his eyes were hoary with madness, his hair like muddy hay, but he loved the landlord's daughter, the landlord's red-lipped daughter. Dumb as a dog, he listened and he heard the robber say, "One kiss, my bunny sweetheart, I'm after a prize tonight, but I shall be back with the yellow gold before the morning light. Yet if they press me sharply and hurry me, through the day, then look for me by moonlight. Watch for me by moonlight. I'll come to there by moonlight, to house by the way." He did not come the journey, he did not come at noon, and out of the tiny sunset before the rays on o' the moon, when the road was a gypsy's ribbon, leaping the purple moor, a red coat trip come marching, marching, marching. King George's man came marching up to the old inn door. They had tied her to a tent with many swinging dress. They had bonded us beside her with a bell with a breath. "Now keep good watch," and they kissed her. She heard the dead man say, "Look for me by moonlight, watch for me by moonlight. I'll come to there by moonlight, through the house of by the way." The top of one finger touched it, stir no more for the rest. Up she stood, up to attack me, the bra. Breathe her deep, she did not risk the hearing, she did not stir again. The road lay far in the moonlight, black and bar in the moonlight, and the glimmer of fangs in the moonlight, trot to a lovely friend. Trot, trot in the frosty silence, trot, trot in the echo night. Nearer he came and nearer, his face like a light. Her eyes were wide for a moment to draw one last deep breath, then a finger moved into moonlight. Her moose in the moonlight, sit her beast in the moonlight and water with her death. He turned his skirt to the west. He did not know who stand guard with her hand, or either must get through with her own red blood. Not till the dawn he heard it. His face grew grey as hair. Help, rest the landlord's daughter, the landlord's black-eyed daughter, had watched her love in the moonlight, died in the darkness there. Back he still like a madman, safe in a curse in the sky, with the road, with the right road smoking behind him, and his wrapper red, his high leg red, were his spirits. Either garden knew, wine red was his violet coat. When they saw him down on the highwayman, down like a dog on the highwayman, and he lay his blood on the highway with the branch of lace at his throat. As still on winter's night, they say, when the wind is in the trees, when the moon is a ghostly galleon, just upon cloudy seas, when the road is in ribbon of moonlight over the purple moor, a highwayman comes riding, riding, riding. A highwayman comes riding up to the old inn door. Over the cobbles he clatters and clars, the dark inn yard. His taps with his whip on the shutters, but all is locked and barred. He whistles through to the window, and who should be waiting there? But the landlord's black-eyed daughter, Bess. The landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot to her long black hair.